Oh my god, finally! Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. This is This One Time I Played, XCOM Edition. I am your host, Unprofessional Tony, and for you, it's probably been maybe a couple minutes, maybe a day or so, if you staggered your video watching. For me, it's been hours. I wanted to tape this so much sooner. I didn't get the chance to because I ran into a couple of things. I'm going to bore you with some techno babble right quick. So, first things first, at the end of my first video, if you saw it, and if you didn't, I'll wait. No, go ahead. Don't mind me. I'll just sit here in complete silence while you go and do that. It just, you know, I got books here. You know, I'm just going to crack open this comic book and you go ahead and you do you. Did you do it? Did you actually go and do it? If you did, then I mean, you're awesome for that. You didn't have to, but anyway, if you saw the end of my last video, this mission originally allowed me to select 4 soldiers, but now I can select 6, and that's because I manipulated the config file while I was in there to have soldiers draw just from my character pool, because I made a character pool of like my best and most frequently used and kind of top soldiers, kind of most talked about soldiers from XCOM Enemy Within's playthrough, and I was going to have them start as my starting 5 or starting 10 because, you know, they're the awesomest, so they should get another chance to be just as awesome. On the flip side, it just means that they might die earlier because, again, as I said in the first video, which if you watched that shit, I said this game was rumored to be hard as fuck. Problem I ran into a couple of times is every time I would set that setting to draw from my character pool, it didn't. It would maybe draw 1 or 2 people, and then it would draw nobody else. And I would get stuck with a bunch of randos. And it would keep doing that. So after hours of scouring Reddit and other places, trying to figure out what the hell is going on, I bulldozed it enough to where it drew those people, and even snuck in another person, because I had to switch some people around because of story raisins. But yeah, while I did that, since I'm so used to Long War giving me the ability to command between six and eight troops at once, I just went ahead and I boosted it to 6 troops as default, and I can get up to 8 after I do some research things. But I don't want to give myself 8 right from the get-go, because this isn't Long War where they overload your missions with enemies. This is just vanilla. I let another modder do that. Anyway, I've babbled enough. I've probably bored you to death. You have probably shut this video off. You're tired of my shit. And you guys want some action. So, let's get my troops in here. First of all, let's get Jane Kelly in here. And the second I get the chance to rename her, I'm going to name her Jane Shepard. Why? Because I had a conversation with a good friend of mine the other day. It's like, you know what? I should put Commander Shepard in this game from Mass Effect. Because Mass Effect is probably among my top 5 favorite game series of all time. And, in that conversation, I was like, yeah, I should put Shepard in. He's awesome. He's like, well, why does he have to be a he? Because I know, you know, you have the selection, you're the option of making Shepard a she. And I go, well, I figured, you know, at this point, you know, it's male. Like, if it's female, she gets married, changes her name. Although, given how Shepard is, they probably wouldn't change her name. He's like, well, she could be already married at this point. It's like, oh, yeah, good point. So, yeah, Jane Kelly to me is Jane Shepard. So, that, as soon as I get the chance to do that, she's going to be changed. Look who's back! Shotgun Dave. If you haven't heard the story and legends of Shotgun Dave, you need to go back and watch XCOM 1. Specifically a terror mission involving nothing but zombies. This man went off and tore the club up. And because I'm such a huge nerd about lore and establishing characters and stuff, Shotgun Dave's biography is, if you watch the last mission of XCOM Enemy Within, where our base got attacked, he was the first person that was in that base attack mission. So I have his story set as he was at that base attack mission. He was with the commander, which is me, as we learned in the last video, up to the very end, up to the point where I got captured and thought I was killed. And Dave's been killing people, killing aliens ever since. But he's back, Shotgun Dave, doing things. Of course, he doesn't have a shotgun right now. We will rectify that later. Here's another. She doesn't have the right attitude, but whatever. I guess I'll fix it when she gets leveled up. Here's another veteran, wily veteran, That's Corinne Dawes. And I'm probably saying her name wrong, but at this point I've given up trying to pronounce that shit right. But anyway, she was infamous for an XCOM Enemy Within for being absolutely horrible. A horrible shot. Because of her, I want to say at least 4 or 5 people because she managed to not hit somebody and they end up getting fucking murdered. So it's probably a couple people, but she got a lot better towards the end of the game, and she was our prime medic. So she's back. She's got a nice little monocle, right? And she's going to be our medic again. This guy should need no introduction. He also has the wrong attitude. What the fuck? This was our primary sniper when it came to Enemy Within. A model could kill somebody from like 200 yards away, no problem. I don't think I've ever seen him miss besides twice. And that was mostly during that last mission because he was shot and panicked and all that sort of good stuff. I hope I did you justification, model, by giving you the Jason hockey mask. I feel that's what you would wear. We will fix the whole attitude and things once we can do that stuff. Of course, our super scout, Bella Brooks. She was the whole reason I started recording this stuff in the first place. So I figured I had to get her in there, and she actually turned out when she got gene modded and stuff. She was like super sneaky. The missions, the unaired, unuploaded missions that you guys missed, she went on a tear. She beat a whole lot of ass. We'll just leave it at that. And then, of course, myself. Because, you know, I'm the commander. I don't stay on the back lines. My quote is, a leader that stays in the rear takes it in the rear. And I'm not that sort of person. I like to be out front, on the front lines with my dudes, with my men and my women, you know. And this is going to be the squad. This is it. This is how it's going down, the first mission. So, without further ado, let's do this. Let's go. I love watching him walk towards the Sky Ranger. It's fucking dope. And again, I apologize for the, if there's graphical hitches or something like this. Like I said in my first video for this game, unfortunately, XCOM came out with a couple of bugs and it was poorly optimized. I know they're looking into it right now. There's people with like machines. Frankly, my computer's no slouch, so I should have no problem running this game. And then there's people like Total Biscuit, whose computer is like worth $4,000 and could absolutely crush any game on the face of this earth. And you know, his game doesn't run as it should when it comes to graphics. But you know, neither here nor there. It's not really that important. It's not like it's a first-person shooter. It just kind of bugs me because I am so used to seeing things in 60 frames per second. It actually kind of physically hurts my eyes when I don't see it like that. But you know, whatever. And of course the whole Jaggy thing. I fucking hate Jaggies, and I wish I could turn AA on, but I can't because AA absolutely slays your frame rate in this game for right now for some reason. Once those game day drivers come out, hopefully things will look a lot better and function a lot better. Alright then, so, if you missed why we're here, we're going to try and steal an Advent power converter, which we need because Dr. Shen's daughter needs it, you know, for reasons I don't know, but I guess she'll reveal those reasons once we get it. And some resistance folks, unaffiliated with us, attacked Advent in an effort to try and take it. I'm guessing, given how this all looks, they lost that fight. So now we're going to go in there, and we're going to take it. And we're in snow. We didn't get to see that a lot last game. I don't think there's really any, there's very few, if any, snow maps in XCOM 1. One thing you'll notice, which is kind of new to XCOM 2, well, not new, but it's going to be used a lot more frequently. Sorry, I'm trying to figure out a place to put her for where she can do maximum harmage, and since she's a ranger, she's gonna always be up front. You might notice in the upper right hand corner where it says converter overload is a time counter. So the developers, and this is sort of had a mixed feeling so far about this. The developers were tired of the Pussyfoot game from XCOM 1, and frankly, it was pretty boring. If you don't know the Pussyfoot strategy of XCOM 1, it was this. You would creep up your point man little by little. You'd use one turn and then go on Overwatch, then use one turn and then you go on Overwatch, and then use one turn and go on Overwatch. That way, when you do run into aliens, you can just pull them back and then set everybody on Overwatch and then, you know, either kill everyone or, you know, whatever. It was a good strategy. Great strategy. Probably the best strategy you could probably pull off. It was also horribly boring. Like, it was seriously terribly boring to watch. It was boring to play. And the devs got sick of that shit. Where did I move him to? Okay, he's over there. So, Amato, I'm going to put you right over here. Or maybe behind this car. No, I'll put you behind the tree. So what they've done in several missions is they've added, you know, a timer. Either a timer to evacuate or a timer to capture something or something like that. We'll do that. But they were tired of that, so now you kind of, you don't have to rush your troops, but you can't sit back there and be like, oh, I'm going to creep up, and then finally, you know, start shooting at people. You got to kind of have to go. And some people, from what I've read on Reddit, don't like it, or they've modded their game to have the turn timer extended. I am going to leave it the way it is, because to me, from being a player that played XCOM Classic, XCOM is about taking risk. You have to take risk. It's something that has to be done every now and then. You can't just, like I said, while it's a good strategy to kind of be cautious, it's really boring. Really boring, and it kind of takes the high risk, high reward feel out of the game. And it especially fits the narrative now, because we're not a well-funded military force. We're basically, you know, guerrilla fighters now. We're the invaders. We're not the defenders. We're the invaders, and they're coming this way. So I like that whole, it fits into the narrative. You have to do things quick. You have to get in, you have to get out. Oh shit, is that car gonna blow? Or am I on fire? Or what? What's happening? Why did I yell out too close to the heat? What's going on? I'm learning still. Okay. I think we're good. Oh, that was him yelling that. Because he might be seen if he pops out. Okay, well then, if you might be seen, Dave, you're gonna kick this shindig off. Corinne, get ready. We're gonna ambush these motherfuckers. We gonna ambush these folks. Ambush these folks. Sorry, it's Super Bowl tomorrow, so... You know, I mean that was that whole Cam Newton thing. That him, the way he explained the whole dab on them folks story was fucking hilarious to me. Anyway, what I'm doing here is I'm going to ambush these dudes. So you're gonna see some actual pretty sweetness go, some dope shit go down here. Oh, I got sight on both of them. Of course, I'm going on Overwatch. All right, that should be enough, Dave. Since they're gonna see you anyway. Kick this shindig off. Shoot him right in the fucking back. Do it, Dave. You missed, but that's fine. Watch this shit. Watch what happens. Alright, cool. So he's seen. And they're gonna try and scatter, but they don't get the free runs anymore. So Amato got his. We got to get that dude. Another good big change in this game that I've absolutely loved. If you watch my last playthrough, how many times did you see me move somewhere to try and get line of sight on somebody and then end up not having line of sight on them? And either it turned into a disaster or, you know, it just didn't work out for me. What they have now is... If you look while I'm mousing around, if you look like right above his head where you see a little target reticle, while I'm mousing around, if you look at all this, you can see where I would move and where I would have line of sight on him. So, for example, if I moved over, if I moved right here, she would not see him. But it seems like anywhere else I move, she'll have line of sight to him and take a shot at him. So, what's that shot? I mean, I know you got a shotgun, but go ahead. Go ahead, Jane. I believe in you. God damn, Jane. Damn. Hostile neutralized. All right then, Jane. Do you? Oh, that was me that was shouting that out. Okay, let me get away from the fire, because apparently I'm frying my own face off. So, and I got 5 turns to get to this thinger here, so I should go and do that. Why is this a fire hazard right here? I don't know, but let's go. And there's other things I got to get to figure out how to do in this game. Like, I know you can move your troops kind of like in a waypoint type system. Like, I could kind of move him and then have him cut this way or something like that. I got to figure out how to do that. Or maybe they'll teach me. Since I'm still technically in the tutorial, maybe they'll teach me that. We've got the objective in sight. Sweet. Oh, it's surrounded, too.
Okay. You should be able to hack into that thing's safety protocols and stabilize it. Shen is uploading the fix right now.
Advent forces on the ground.
Do they see us? Do they see us? They see us! Okay. Alright. Ooh. Ooh, he ran up. He's in cover. Or he's not in cover, but... I'll go ahead, Dave. Take a shot. Alright. I mean, I know you're used to a shotgun, so... It's cool, man. Just hang out there. Amato... I gotta put you somewhere, because I don't want him moving towards this way and then getting a bead on you. But that might be safe. Oh, you got the... Oh, because he's out in the open. Get him, Amato. That didn't used to be you, buddy. Like, okay, if you had your sniper rifle, he would be dead. He'd have been dead. Dead. D-E-D. Let's see, where am I going to put Bella? I wonder if I can sneak... Oh, I don't want to sneak around too far, because if I do that, she might be liable to get her face melted. And I don't want that to happen. But I will put her in the backwoods, because that way she can probably... This is what I did with her in the last game. She would go way out of the way, because she could move so far, she would go way out of her way, and then when she... once you got in a proper position, which sounds bad when I say it out loud, but once you got in a proper position, it would be just lights out for whoever was in her way. Get right here, Jane, because I got to get you. We got 5 turns to get to that converter and hack it before, I guess I'm guessing before it blows up, given from what happened in the intro, with them just, you know, chilling and walking there. That's 45. I'm gonna go on Overwatch. Troll Doctor.
Roger that.
Go over this way. I like her color scheme. I think I did really well on her color scheme, by the way. I just want to put that out there. Get up on the truck. All right, Advent. What do you got? Oh, please get this. But look at that environmental damage. God damn. Oh, I'm not going to get this. I know I'm not. Yeah. I like how when they run, they duck their head down now when they get shot at. That's fucking dope. Oh, he marked Jane for death. That's not bueno. That's not bueno at all. That's the opposite of bueno. Hey, man. Hey. All right. Okay, if that's how you want to do, we can do that. Amato, can you get a bead on these assholes? Ah, oh, no flank. 49, 46. This is what we're going to do, Amato. This is what we're going to do. We're going to say, fuck this guy. Yeah, fuck this guy. Blow him up. Oh, shit. We got to get away from the truck. Everybody away from the truck. Got to get away from the truck. Away from the truck. Away from the truck.
Order's confirmed. On the move.
Okay, you can't. You won't make the shot on this, but let's take his cover at least and damage him a little bit. Gotta play that cover destruction game. Oh, the tree is still up. But he's hurt. He's severely hurt. Ooh, look at Bella. She got primo real estate. She'd see him from... she'd have no cover, though. All right. Get behind the house. Hopefully there's nothing in the house. Oh, yeah, that's right. Hey, Jane, you want to kill this guy? Watch this shit. Watch her be an extreme G right now. Ah, the camera fucked it up. But you get the gist of what she did, right? You know? Troll Doctor, away from the truck. Away from the... You know what? Get away from both trucks. I'm pretty sure once that one blows up, the other one's going to blow, too. Which means I gotta get out the truck. Or get off the truck. I wish I had a med kit for you, too. You're probably gonna be down at least like 30 days or some shit. I might as well just creep up this way. Alright. Oh, right. The whole thing with the grenade. Here's another glitch in the game, how sometimes the game takes too long to think. There you go. See?
If we don't stabilize the converter soon, I don't think anybody's going home today.
All right, Central. I know you took a bullet from me and everything when you carried my body out of that little cell pod thing, but I mean, you ain't got to remind me. I know what's at stake and what's going down here. All right, Dave. Do you see anything around that converter before I rush Jane in there to hack it? Get behind the truck. No? All right. Okay, Bella. All right, I want you peek out that window in the house. See if you see anything. Oh shit! That's not good at all. Yeah, those are the new sectoids. They took some steroids. Human steroids, apparently. And they're now bulkier and beefier. And they can mind control you from the get-go. They don't have to. You don't have to wait till they evolve later in the game to do that. They'll just fucking do it. Damn, I gotta get that converted. I got two turns to do this. This is why I like the new timer clock, because now there's a whole lot of tension built into the game. There's tension. I gotta get to that Jim Jam joint there. Do I wanna risk putting Jane over there so she can get the converter? I think I don't. I think I wanna put Jane right here so she can get it next turn. 44, 26, 13. Anyone in grenade range? No. Okay, well, save it and go on Overwatch, Jane. Alright, Amato, that truck's already been blown up, so you should be safe there. Safe from that, I should say. Get behind this truck. You're gonna cover Jane when she gets that converter, buddy. Troll Doctor, I want you out of harm's way, but I also want you to kill something, too, because I want you to get promoted. So, get in the house. In the house. Oh, that's not good. That's not gonna be good at all. Hey, man, fuck you.
I'm pinned down here.
It's cool, Bella. You're alright. You're fine. Ah, shit, I ran my ass out into... Okay, cool. Alright, I can deal with that. Hey, man. Fuck you. Listen, you can't blame me for panicking. I spent like 20 years in a cryo suit, you know, getting things shoved into my brain and who knows God what else, you know. So I'm a little rusty. Cut me some slack. Hack that damn thing. All right, let's play the hacking mini game. What can we do? She has 0% chance of doing any of this stuff. So we're going to try the extreme, of course, and see if we get lucky. Not even close. Not even close. Not even within a panty sniff's distance of that. But mission complete, though. We did what we came to do. Oh, she's out in the open. Oh, for sure. Oh, snap. Can I? I don't know what that's getting ready to do, Bella, but I want you to do it. What the fuck happened? What? Is it the thing in the back of the truck? Because that's dope as hell. Oh, yeah. I guess some acid or something leaked out of there. Damn, Bella. You dope. All right, then, Bella. Way to use the environment to your advantage. All right, Corinne. Corinne, get next to that window, and then, like, I want to see if you can blow that dude up. Closing on target position. Hopefully I don't get you shot in the fucking face. I know you probably just gave me a pep talk just now to, you know, get my shit right. Can I get both? No, I can't. All right, well, blow him up. Good job. And you got a promotion. All right, Sectoid, it's just you now. What you got, baby? What's going on? The Sectoids, I mean, they're super dangerous now. Damn, he's super hard to hit. Either that or we suck. Go ahead, take that gamble. Again, if you had your sniper rifle, this dude would be dead. Maybe it's because they're rookies. We're all rookies, so our aim is fucking horrible. Oh, he's run out of ammo. Dave, we're going to try and creep up on the side of this dude and flank him. But I don't want to run you too. Oh, can you flank him already? Oh, take the shot. Shotgun Dave. Nice. Grazed him, but you got him. Put some hurt on him. Oh, he don't even know what to do. Oh, yeah. This is another new trick. The Sector is new. Watch this. They can raise the dead.
No respite for the dead. The aliens have found a way to mind control them now.
Yeah. Sectoids are on steroids now. Alright, cool. I'm normal again. But the good thing about that is if you kill a Sectoid, then that automatically kills a zombie. And look who has a grenade. So we're going to destroy his cover. Possibly him too. If I can get the fucking angle right. I don't think she's got. Well, no, I just had it. You know what? We're going to move. We're just going to move. Bella, get behind this box and then... You should have clear throwing thingers. I know, real technical, right? Oh, you got his ass now. Yeah, that's what I like. That's what I like to see. This, all that right there. No cover. Zero coverage. All right. Guess what season it is? If your guess was clapback season... You've guessed right, because I'm going to risk my own ass out there, because he's got no cover, and I'm going trying to get my payback. This is for making me panic and shoving things up my nose. Nice. Drop team. And now that zombie should drop, too. Good boy. That should be game, right? Beautiful. Beautiful. Ah, nice ride back. Everybody's all smiles. Look at them. Everybody's all smiles. Yeah, buddy. Yeah, look at me. I'm all smiles. I love this post-mission stat sheet. If I would move out the way, I'd be able to read better. So, Jane, of course, had the most damage dealt. Dave made the most attacks. Damn. Bella was the most under fire and moved the farthest. That's weird because we started moving her like on the outskirts of the map, and she got under fire by like most of the aliens on the map. It's funny to me. Well, not funny, but you know. I love this screen too, the post promote screen. How they triumphantly walk out of the Sky Ranger. First, we're going to take Corinne to the med bay because she is super hurt. But let's promote her.
Operating some of our most advanced equipment, specialists deploy robotic drones on the battlefield that can be outfitted for combat or field medic duty.
So this is Corinne and her new drone, Leeches. She requested me to start calling her drone Leeches. So that's its name. It's Leeches. Leeches! Yeah, she's kind of disappointed that... Oh, you're only down 10 days. You'll be fine. You'll be fine, Corinne. Let's see. Dave, get promoted.
Just like it sounds, our sharpshooters engage enemy targets with pinpoint accuracy from extreme range. They're also trained in pistol marksmanship for the occasional close encounter.
I'm still going to keep your name a shotgunner, but apparently you... traded that in for a sniper rifle. That's fine. And you also have like a goddamn hand cannon. Alright then. We'll go with that. Let's go and promote Bella. Let's see what she turns into.
Serving as our demolitions experts, the Grenadiers provide heavy ordnance delivery whenever and wherever we need it.
So I've given Bella a heavy gun and some bombs. That's going to go really well for Advent. Actually, that's not going to go well at all. and we'll promote you two later. I want to see what's next in the story.
These items should prove useful in our ongoing efforts against the aliens. When you have a moment, Commander, I have made some interesting discoveries as they relate to the implant we removed from you earlier.
Okie doke. I want to see what was in my brain. Yeah, help her out, you assholes. What kind of men are you? You see a woman pushing a heavy-ass thing, and you're just going to sit there like, yeah, that's the thing, all right. Dicks. Dicks. All right, let's talk to Dr. Shen. Or Shen's daughter.
Okay, reworked your repulsors with some of the parts I salvaged from their old engine. Should fix that stabilization problem you had. Come on, Rover. It'll work. Commander! Getting our tech to talk to theirs is harder than you think. Lily Shen, Chief Engineer, at your service. You were probably expecting to see my father. In all that's happened, I'm guessing Central didn't tell you yet. He's gone. Dad gave everything he had to get us this far. This entire ship is his life's work. I know he would have loved to show you around the place himself. He used to talk about you a lot. You can be sure I'm ready to finish what he started. Might not look it, but from here, I can fabricate pretty much anything you come up with. And with a little more help, well, you'd be amazed what I can do.
That's kind of sad that...
It was an honor to finally meet you, Commander.
It's kind of sad that Dr. Shen died, but I mean, he was old as fuck, too, so...
Miracles, Commander, but I should be able to put some of the stuff together in no time at all. I'd suggest we get started with the medkit. It'll probably come in handy sooner rather than later.
Yeah, you're probably right about that, so go ahead up and do that.
Looks like Tigan has made progress on his research.
We should meet him in the lab.
That was in my brain? That cannot, could not have been comfortable.
Much of my own research based upon this simple design. If only I had known.
Ah, Commander, excellent timing. There's been some progress. I've managed to break down several key components of the chip implanted into your skull. My analysis reveals that its primary function was that of a conduit, passing a vast amount of data directly to your cerebral cortex. With the primary connection severed, much of that data is lost. Several fragments do remain, however. Ghosts, if you will. Observe. Tactical combat simulations. War games. The sheer volume of encounters you were processing was astounding. It is truly remarkable that you survived as long as you did.
Well, I'm kind of a boss.
Disconcerting, there is still some good news. This chip bears a striking resemblance to a medical implant I briefly assisted in developing at the gene therapy clinic in New Providence. My understanding was that the implants were intended for high-ranking Advent officers only, captains or above. Retrieving a chip from such an officer would be the only way to know for certain. A greater understanding of these implants would undoubtedly benefit us all, Commander.
So I take it you want me to steal one from one of their brains.
New objective added.
Hey, did I call it or what?
The Advent officers have clearly been modified to allow for their subordinates to receive new orders psionically. The implanted chip is the key.
While that would probably be the best thing story-wise to research, I want to mod my guns.
I do find that area of research to be among the more intriguing options available.
Me too.
I'll send word when a complete report is available.
Looks like Shen got that converter up and running, Commander. We're ready for you on the bridge.
There's also something going on in the armory? Oh, yeah, promotions. Derp. Derp, derp, derp. Let me save my game, because I haven't yet. Jesus Christ. Did they autosave enough? Well, you know what? Let's clean that. Let's clean that. Clean that. Get that one. Oh, yeah, that was the one from the... Yeah. All right. Okay. Yeah. You know what? Yes. 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 We're just going to call this XCOM North America. We're back, baby, because that's where we were last time. So, anyway, let's see what they need at the bridge.
Just stay clear of the perimeter. Understood?
Commander. Good. I think we got something here. Despite all of Advent's efforts, there are still people who refuse to believe their lies. And it's time we let them know they're not alone. We've already located a target for our first operation.
Sir, given our current location, there's actually no way the Sky Ranger could reach that position.
Who said anything about the Sky Ranger? Shen, status report. Are we ready?
Short answer, yes. But you might all want to hold on to something.
So, instead of having an underground base like we did before, if you're a fan of the Avengers or Marvel in general, we've got our own helicarrier. Boom, bitches. Yeah, who needs an underground base? We learned our lesson last time when they destroyed that shit.
Sector 14, East Asia.
We're ready to start making moves, Commander. By hitting Advent wherever we find them, we can help strengthen the resistance. In return, they'll contribute material and personnel to support our operations.
Okay. Well then, I guess we're going to save Dr. Polina Gusava in East Asia. So, Yeah, I guess we're going to go launch. And we will equip one of our soldiers with it, and we will deploy next time. Oh, I did it again. Ah, shit. Well, be sure to tune in for that shit, because, you know, XCOM 2, we're rolling now that I think I've gotten things to get to be the way that I want, configuration-wise. So, with that said, like, comment, subscribe, dislike, wave flags, send me messages, send me hate mail, send me hate, don't send me hate mail, send me cupcakes, send me Oreos. Now I want something sweet, so I'm gonna go handle that business. You handle your own business, and enjoy the Super Bowl. Have a safe Super Bowl Sunday, and I'll holla at you later. Oh, stay woke. I almost forgot. Stay on alert. You don't know who could or what could be out there. So do that. Now I'll holla.